Welcome to another release of Bforartists 4 version 4.3.2. Finally, this release is based on the latest from Blender of 4.3.2 and 4.4.0 alpha in development. This release has a splash screen kindly provided by Ethan Avila, second place from the last splash screen competition from the Discord community. It's a beautiful piece. And with that, this release is focused primarily on the Colored Collection Rose release with another 139 and 37 extra tasks of this particular point update with a ton more from Blender. So let's take a closer look. First, we have Colored Collection Rose. Thanks to Pablo Vasquez for recommending us this code and allowing us to adopt it. With the Colored Collections, with this piece provided by Masuka, you go into your preferences, go into your editing tab, then go inside the Outliner submenu and turn on Colored Collection Rose. This will give us the ability to assign a color to a collection and use them as a visual cue or overlay system to help us see what collection does what. And if you want, you can also assign sub-collections into a collection. For example, this green collection inside of a red collection. Next, we have the new Grease Pencil default assets for the new asset shelves in the 3D view. We have a piece provided by Kuklis, who has been very kind to share his art with us. And we have these new Grease Pencil assets and ability to change the thumbnails quickly with some buttons. So these Grease Pencil assets are now able to be dragged and dropped in from the space. So for example, we can change the colors inside of the modifier stack. We can also change the opacity. We can also change the screen space width, which means if we zoom the camera in or out of this space, so let's just do that, we'll zoom out, it will hold the dimensions of the grease pencil, no matter how far away or how close we are from it. And we also have the ability to change the softness. More assets are coming in the future, which means life is going to be super fun and interesting, especially with the drag and drop directly from the asset shelf inside of the 3D view. With the power user tools, we have a new silhouette toggle for the 3D view. This piece was kindly provided by Bel Sunze for his upcoming short film. This is one of my favorites of this week. With the power user tools, we now have a new button to control when we want to see the silhouette to help us with read or sculpting with a quick toggle. And this will also remember whatever view that we were using. So for example, if I was in workbench mode or in wireframe mode, I can switch the toggle, switch back, and it will remember those settings. With the asset shelf, we have new default categories displayed and new shelf type tags to filter your assets per the shelf. This piece was kindly provided by Timon, which has a beautiful sense of detail and texturing. I really love this model called the Dragonfly Shuttle. The new tag system and default categories now implies that you can now organize and assign which asset goes to which asset shelf using tags. For example, if you want a shader node group to show up in the shader node tabs, you can tag it with shader and it will show up in these panels. If you want a geometry nodes node group to show up in the 3D view, you can now tag it as a geometry nodes, which will also show in the geometry nodes tree, but some node groups do not apply to the 3D view, meaning you can also tag a node group as 3D view to also show in the 3D view asset shelf. Grease Pencil 3 has also had a feature parity and polish update throughout this release. This next piece is done by White Rooster Productions and Chris Kuhn, who modeled the piece and was textured together based off the Enterprise Star Trek model. Beautifully done. So the smart delete has been now made smarter. Now you can delete, 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 and delete, and it will go away. And if you also use edges, you can also delete and it will hold the pieces together and then collapse and make them go away. If you have multiple islands, you can also delete your islands no matter the mode that you're in, and they will also disappear. This next piece is done by Mahid Sheikh. He maintains the Flatpak. This new feature also is about something very similar to Minecraft. If you go inside of your navigation menu, go inside of your walk menu, you have a new horizontal lock. Navigation walk mode. So now you can use your navigation walk mode locked to a plane as if you were in creative mode inside of Minecraft. And we've done general maintenance, details, tooltips, refinement to everything new coming from Blender. This next piece is done by Sean Robertson. So what's new from Blender? We have text editing in the sequencer, and we have a lot more coming in. A lot. So I highly recommend you check out the Blender release notes to see what's new, but let's take a closer look. And last but certainly not least, this piece is done by Tet Kaneda. And we will be showcasing now the new nodes from geometry nodes, including a find and string and a number of others. We also have new shading nodes like the Gaber texture and the metallic BSDF. This piece is absolutely gorgeous. If you like what you saw today, give it a try. It is 100% free. Download it from bforartists.de/download or from the Windows App Store or the Blender Launcher version 2. This project is thanks to you for your artwork and your support. And I want to say thanks to Eyad for helping maintain the weekly merges, to Reiner for founding this project and helping do some of the maintenance, to Teleporte, my brother, for sponsoring most of my work. Andrea Stevens, which is myself, sponsors this particular project by developing on GitHub. And I do this thanks to the people who follow me on Patreon. So let's be for artists and keep making art and great stuff today.